preparation is labeled sterile, it means that it is entirely devoid of viable organisms. Nonetheless, it is impractical to test everything to ensure that there are no living organisms present due to statistical and biological limitations. Even if a portion of the batch is tested, there is a chance that only some contaminants will be detected by testing methods. As a result, even if an item is labeled as sterile, testing cannot assure that the entire batch is completely free of living organisms. This is the reason that USP Chapter 797 emphasizes the importance of properly preparing sterile drugs to ensure the final product is safe for patients. The recent changes have added an additional layer of sterility assurance to compounded sterile preparations. Requirements for radiopharmaceuticals are no longer addressed in the revised 797 standards. Instead, radiopharmaceuticals are subject to meet the requirements outlined in USP 825. Previously, all aqueous bronchial and nasal inhalation preparations had to be sterile. The new revision of 797 clarifies that only aqueous pulmonary inhalation preparations are required to be sterile, while nasal dosage forms intended for local application are not required to be sterile. Sterility testing is required for all Category 3 compounded sterile preparations and for the aseptically processed and terminally sterilized compounded sterile preparations that will be assigned the longer beyond use dates per Category 2. The beyond use date limits are specified in Tables 13 and 14 of the To Be Official 797 chapter. For the 797 revisions, sterility testing can be performed utilizing the traditional USP-71 sterility test or an alternative method that is comparable and non-inferior to the traditional test. ScanRDI is an effective rapid sterility test method that offers results in as little as 1 day, compared to the traditional method that requires an incubation time of at least 14 days. This rapid sterility test method is especially beneficial for sterility testing of short shelf life products and those compounded sterile preparations prepared for immediate use. This alternative technology, which is currently accepted in the pharmaceutical industry, will now be accepted per the revised 797 standards if the appropriate validations are performed. Specifically, the revised chapter mentions the requirement to perform a method suitability test for all sterility test methods to demonstrate that the product does not inhibit the detection of microorganisms from tested samples. The latest version of USP 797 has clarified the number of units to undergo sterility testing of batches less than 40, unlike the previous version that referred to USP 71. Which had a minimum requirement of 4 units for sterility testing regardless of batch size. Revisions to the chapter require that only 10% of the units prepared, rounded to the nearest whole number, be tested for sterility. In practice, it means a smaller number of units to be tested. The USP Chapter 797 has undergone significant changes to clarify the quality standards in the healthcare industry and provide more detailed descriptions of how to meet these expectations. This will help compounders better understand and follow the standards. Visit eagleanalytical.com/USP-revisions for more information. And contact our client care team if you need assistance with sterility testing, including the faster alternative rapid scan RDI methodology.